Chapter 75. An attempted theft ends in failure. Yu Hua challenged the Zhou army again the next day. This time Thunderbolt met him. Yu Hua was very ugly, with a yellow face and red whiskers. "Are you Yu Hua? You rebel. Don't you know me?" Thunderbolt flew into the air to attack Yu Hua, who used his blood-converting dagger to stab him in the wing. Luckily, his wings had grown from two fairy apricots, so he did not die at once. He fell down but managed to struggle back to see Jiang Ziya, only adding to Jiang's anxiety. Yu Hua came again the next day, but Jiang Ziya ordered the board of truce to be hung up. Yang Jian arrived the following day. Seeing the board, he wondered to himself, "It's been nearly 10 months, but we haven't even begun to move into Shang territory. What's wrong here?" When he reported his arrival with the fresh load of food supplies, Jiang said, "We have enough food here, but it seems that we cannot move forward. What shall we do?" "Take the board down, uncle. I'll meet him." Just then a Taoist lad came to see the commander. He kowtowed and said, "I'm a disciple of Fairy Primordial. I've come to take Neja back to the mountain for medical treatment." Jiang Ziya agreed. Looking at Thunderbolt closely, Yang Jian saw that he was shivering constantly. His blood was like thick ink. After a long time, Yang Jian said definitely, "This must be the effect of some poison." The board was removed, and Yu Hua came again the next day. Yang Jian rode out to meet him and could see at once that he had magic powers. He yelled, "Is that Yu Hua coming?" "Yes. Tell me your name." "I'm Commander Jiang's nephew." Yang replied, attacking Yu Hua with his cutlass. After about 20 rounds, Yu Hua attacked with his blood-converting dagger, and Yang Jian let himself be hit in the left arm. He returned to camp but could not make out what kind of poison it was. He then told Jiang Ziya he would go to Mount Jade Spring to see his master for help. When he got to Golden Haze Cave, Yang Jian knelt before Jade Tripod and kowtowed. "Yang Jian, what do you have to tell me now?" the immortal asked. "Yu Hua has a poisonous dagger, but we can't recognize the poison. He stabbed both Neja and Thunderbolt, making them cold and unable to speak. Can you tell us what the poison is? Show me your wound." Inspecting his arm, Jade Tripod said, "This is from blood-converting dagger. Mortals will die at once if hit, but Neja's made of lotus flowers and Thunderbolt's wings are fairy apricots. Without your magic powers, you'd have all died by now." He then continued, "The dagger's from Yu Yun of Panglai Island. Three pills were refined with the dagger, and they alone can save you. Only you can carry this out." He then whispered what to do to Yang. Delighted at his master's words, Yang Jian left for Panglai Island, where he transformed himself into Yu Hua. When he knelt down, Yu Yoi asked, "What brings you here?" "By your order, I went to Sishui Pass to help the Shang Dynasty. I first wounded Neja and then Thunderbolt." When Yang Jian came, he pointed at the dagger with his finger and turned it back on me. "I was hit on the shoulder, and so I've come to beg you to save me from death." Yu Yan was shocked. "How can this be? I've got some medicine which can take care of the problem. You may have all three pills in case you have another accident." Yang Jian thanked him and hurriedly left the cave. After his departure, Yu Yan began to ponder. "How could Yang Jian turn my dagger back? How could Yu Hua have gotten here if he was really seriously mounted?" When he had made a calculation on his fingers and found out the truth, he roared with anger. "Damn you, Yang Jian! How dare you steal my pills? I'll never forget this insult." He raced after him on his golden-eyed camel, but when Yang Jian heard the rustling of the wind behind him, he secretly set his sky-barking hound into the sky. It bit Yu Yon's neck, tearing off a big piece of hit mink robe. Yu Yon cried with hatred, "I'll go back for now, but I'll get you soon enough." Jiang Ziya was delighted to see the pills. They cured Thunderbolt first and then sent Mu Jia to deliver the elixir to Ne Jia. Meeting Yu Hua the next day, Yang Jian bluffed. Yu Hua, I was wounded the day before yesterday, but luckily I had the pills to save my life. The dagger and the pills were refined in the same furnace at the same time. How could he have gotten hold of them? What use is my dagger if it be so? Yu Hua pondered. He spurred his golden-eyed beast forward to fight with Yang Jian. After 30 rounds, Thunderbolt flew over, yelling, "Damn you, Yu Hua! Don't go away. I must give vent to my hatred." Thunderbolt aimed at his head, and Yu Hua resisted with his halberd. Trying to repulse Yang Jian, he had no time to return another blow from Thunderbolt. When he dodged to evade the cudgel, his golden-eyed beast was hit. It jumped and threw Yu Hua to the ground. Yang Jian quickly killed him. Han Rong was extremely worried at the loss of Yu Hua. He murmured, "The reinforcements haven't arrived. How can we defend the pass?" Yu Yuan arrived at this critical moment. His face was indigo blue, his hair red, and he sported two long tusks. He was 17 feet tall, and strong light beamed from his eyes. Han Rong went forward to greet Yu Yuan and asked, "Which honorable cave and mountain do you come from, master?" "Yang Jian has gone too far this time. He stole my elixir and killed my disciple Yu Hua. I'm Yu Yuan, first vitality fairy of Peng Lai Island. I've come to get revenge for Yu Hua." Han Rong held a feast to entertain Yu Yuan, who went out the next day to challenge Jiang Ziya. Jiang Ziya led his troops to the battlefield, where Yu Yuan demanded, "Jiang Ziya, tell Yang Jian to come out and see me. Yang Jian is not here. He's busy transporting food supplies. As you have studied the way, you certainly know the will of heaven. You will die if you hinder our advance. Can't you see what happened to Yu Hua and the others?" Jiang Ziya declared. Yu Yuan roared, "Your nonsense only fools the people. We can't remove the source of trouble if I don't end your life." He spurred his five-cloud camel forward to attack Jiang, who returned the blow with his sword. Li Jing and Wei Hu rushed in to aid Jiang. Yu Yuan threw up his golden light file, but Jiang unrolled his yellow apricot flag to protect himself. Yu Yuan could only turn to attack Li Jing, but he was caught unawares by Jiang's staff for beating gods. He was hit on the back, and his samadhi fire was knocked right out of him. He was then stabbed in the thigh by Li Jing. He patted his camel's neck and raced away. As Earth Traveler Sun was returning with more food supplies, he saw Yu Yuan's camel on its beam of golden light. "If I had that beast, how convenient it would be," he mused. That evening, Earth Traveler Sun said to Dong Chanyu, "I like Yu Yuan's beast very much. I think I'll go and steal it to use as my mount. What do you think?" "You should report to Commander Jiang first," Dong Chanyu advised. "It's not necessary to report this. I'll be back very soon," Sun replied. Near the second watch, he twisted his body into the ground and went directly into Sishui Pass. He entered the headquarters, where he found Yu Yuan in meditation with his eyes closed. He waited there patiently. Yu Yuan's meditation was suddenly disturbed. He found out with a prediction on his fingers that Earth Traveler Sin was planning to steal his five-cloud camel. He began to snore loudly, and Sun grinned in delight. Clutching his iron cudgel, Earth Traveler Sun strode quietly through the corridor till he found the five-cloud camel tied to a post with a rope. He led the camel to a red stepping stone, where he was able to clamber up on its back. He then dismounted and hit Yu Yuan heavily on the head. His samadhi fire was knocked out, but Yu Yuan did not move. Earth Traveler Sun struck another blow, but there was still no reaction. "That bloody Taoist is crazy. I must return now, but I'll deal with him tomorrow," Earth Traveler Sun murmured. He mounted the five-cloud camel again, and when he patted its neck, golden light shot from its four hooves. It rose and flew lightly into the air. Sun was overjoyed. Once in the air, Sung hoped to leave the pass at once, but the camel turned and landed back inside the wall. Yu Yuan grabbed him by the hair and shouted, "I've caught a thief trying to steal my camel." Everybody came running with their torches and lanterns. When Han Rong had seated himself in court, he saw Yu Yuan hurry forward, carrying a dwarf by the hair. "Why are you carrying him like that? Put him down, master." Han Rong said, "Oh, no. This dwarf can travel underground. He'd be gone at once if I put him down. How should we deal with him, master?" Han Rong asked. "Give me that bag under my rush cushion. I'll put him inside and burn him to death." A fire was quickly built, and Yu Yuan ordered, "Hang the universal bag over the fire." "What a fire! This must be my end," Earth Traveler Sun screamed. Krakukanda was in meditation when White Crane Lad arrived to report the urgent situation. Krakukanda went immediately to Sishui Pass. He invoked a violent whirlwind, swooped down, and snatched up the universal bag. When his bag disappeared in the whirlwind, Yu Yuan roared, "Bloody Krakukanda! You've taken my universal bag. I'll get even with you tomorrow." Krakukanda went to the Zhou camp and asked for Jiang Ziya. Jiang got up at once and went out to meet him. "What's happened?" he asked. "I came to rescue Earth Traveler Sun," the immortal replied. "How can that be? He just got here yesterday with our food supplies," Jiang said in astonishment. Krakukanda opened the universal bag and set Earth Traveler Sun free. After he told his story, Jiang became very angry. He said, "You ought to have asked my permission. You must be severely dealt with, and am warning to other offenders. Take him out and behead him at once. Earth Traveler Sun deserves to be punished, but we still need him. I beg you to forgive him and give him a chance to redeem his crime," Krakukanda implored the commander. "I will forgive him at your request, brother," Jiao replied. The next day, Yu Yuan rushed over to the Zhou camp, demanding to meet Krakukanda alone.